Hump, why'd you assemble that rifle so fast? Because you told me to, Drill Sergeant. Well, everybody, Connor McIver, welcome to another episode of our foreclosure show. This is our Hump Day broadcast, talking about foreclosures, distressed inventory, giving you those real numbers. Then, of course, this is also our daily real estate radio show, talking about other things that actually make a difference in the world as far as how people approach real estate and how you do as well. Some of the best online systems that we put together, we also present on this show. We did that yesterday, and today, of course, is the Foreclosure REO Wednesdays. So before we get to that, the ways to search and clearing up some fallacies about foreclosures, we can definitely start getting into some of the email that we've received, at least one of them talking about foreclosures, and we'll do that in the email segment. Now, I'm, of course, Connor McIver, RE/MAX's Paris 911 team. We're real estate agents headquartered here in Santa Clarita Valley, serving the real estate needs of those of you in greater L.A. So Santa Clarita, greater L.A., Antelope Valley, we reach out there. Ventura County, we reach out there as well. Anything that is L.A. and around, we're pretty much there. So reach out to us if we can help. Online is paris911.com, P-A-R-I-S-911.com. Paris is a person. Not that person, and I was a 911 for a long time with LAPD, so there you go. Moving into what's going on here within the real estate venue, we do have our daily recap of the market, so we will talk about that right now. The last 24 hours of real estate market activity have given us 5 new listings have hit the market. You want to see what those are? You can go to our main site, paris911.com, punch in the word new. N-E-W into the Mac box. We have 7 properties that have experienced price changes. A majority of those are going to be reductions from list price to list price. You can use those terms as well into the Mac box at our main site at paris911.com. You can punch in the words price changes and see which properties actually had theirs adjusted most recently. Back on market properties 5, those are 5 properties that have fallen from grace, actually fallen from escrow, and now they are back on the market for sale, known as BOMs, B-O-M in the real estate industry. That is the vernacular we use. You can punch in those 3 letters, B-O-M, into the Mac box at the top part of paris911.com and see which properties those were. We do have 3 properties that entered escrow into the backup offer status. Typically, that's what happens if there's only 1 or maybe 2 offers right at the onset. Once an offer is signed off on by the seller and it's fully executed by all parties, typically that agent's first step is going to be into the backup position. Sometimes I remember back in the bank days when the banks were running the inventory not so many years ago here in this last foreclosure cycle. With us, whenever we would get multiple offers on properties, we already had the backup offers. So we went right from active to pending status. And in that case out here, we have 6 properties that enter pending status also. But usually that's a step up from being in backup. Then the next graduation is pending. Something to think about. It doesn't always mean that once a property is on the market active, it's going to go right into backup. Some agents, because they have multiple offers or they feel so confident with the offer they have, they fire it right off into pending and totally skip backup, which you can do. 2 properties expired in the last 24 hours, meaning they just didn't sell within contractual time frames, and the time was up, whatever that was, 3 months, 6 months, 1 month, 2 weeks, 5 years, whatever it may have been. And then finally, we have 10 properties that sold and closed escrow here in the Santa Clarita Valley. One of the things I want to get into before we talk about our foreclosure recap is wanted to talk about an email that we got by Lou. And Lou wanted to know, as far as foreclosures go, what are the secrets? How do we, because he watches apparently a lot of late night television, as was referenced in his email, and he wants to know what the best way is to buy these properties. Well, Lou, it's going to be kind of a boots on the ground thing. You're definitely going to want to do your due diligence. You're going to want to find out about these properties, and it's going to also depend on ownership. It might be that a best case scenario would be for you to have your very diligent and hardworking real estate agent do some follow-ups on properties that have had notice of defaults filed on them. I'll give you those numbers, Lou, here in the next segment, and you will see what kind of numbers we're talking about. So there's a good potentiality there. The other thing, bank-owned properties, the actual bank-owned foreclosures, sometimes they're kind of in limbo. Nothing's happening. There's no change to their status. They are foreclosures. They are vacant. Sometimes those properties, a very simple letter works. Sometimes we actually have a contact within the bank that can hunt down that particular asset by address and find it on their tally sheet and figure out what they might want to do with it. Again, another step by a proactive agent or realtor team. Looking for those auctions, of course, auctions are cash all day long. Need cashier's checks to go in there. If that's something you're interested in, again, you're going to have to find an agent that knows how to do the auction scene. There's a lot of due diligence that has to happen prior to you even going and raising your paddle or raising your hand and bidding on property number one. So let's get into the foreclosure inventory. All right, so now we're going to get into the numbers. I did most of the recording earlier. We're going to get into Santa Clarita, looking at all distressed. 290 happen to be re-in. We have 83 auctions in there, 76 bank-owned properties, and 111 pre-foreclosures. Now, that's everything. Looking at Valencia, a total of 84 distressed properties, breaking that down. Canyon Country, total of 98 distressed. Castaic, there's 46 currently distressed. And these are going to be, of course, made up of the pre-foreclosure, the bank on the auction, also the property sold to thirds. Also, Saugus, a total of 6 distressed. Stevenson Ranch, 33. Granada Hills, 140. Northridge, 216. Threw some of those cities in. Palmdale, 684. Big. Lancaster, 705. There you go. Simi Valley, 235 distressed properties. Now, as far as this update goes, this was, of course, done December 17th. That's what day we're on. And we happen to be Wednesday, which is our typical foreclosure hump day update for Santa Clarita and surrounding cities. Now, you can get more information. You can see these properties by going to foreclosures.scv.house or, of course, paris911.com. Click on the foreclosures tab. Now, this data is going to be our local date, 2014.351. That's going to be our show date, 351st day of the year. And on that same system, you can send us your criteria, and I'll be happy to pull foreclosures and bank owned from our system that we do have in place and send those over to you, and then you can decide how you want us to approach them, be it some kind of a hard door knock, boots on the ground fashion, mailing, or even if, you know, then we'll be able to run you through and figure out if we can even go to that next step. Now, one of the things I wanted to point out, today's tip of the day is going to be, don't believe everything you see on TV. I know at 3 and 4 in the morning, there are those infomercials telling you how to get rich by selling distressed properties, foreclosures, finding those people that have lost their property at a tax sale or whatever it may be. Just be careful. Have a seat. Sit down with that real estate agent you trust. If you're out here in Greater LA, Santa Clarita, give us a call. Come out to my office. We'll sit down and talk. But ask those questions. You know, what is that all about? Let them explain it to you. And, of course, anything you see online, you want to make sure you're going to double-check that. You don't want to just take anything you read online, take that word for it, thinking that this is really the way to go. Don't give up too much of your personal information. Just be careful. If you are going to do that, make sure it is a local system, a local agent, so you're not going to get spammed through the gills. Also, only make sure you're going to be working with experts. Read everything that you're signing and always have a backup plan. You can see this. The presentation that we did this morning by going to our main site at paris911.com and punching into the Mac box the words foreclosure update, you'll be able to see that. Now, tomorrow we're going to have our Truth in Lending broadcast. It's going to be pretty good. We're going to be speaking about some of the things to look for when you are going to be approaching a lender wanting to borrow money on real estate. And also, we should have more information on that new Fannie Mae Freddie Mac 3% down product. I know Paris pointed that out to me a couple weeks ago when she read the intel online. We're still waiting for a lot of the local lenders to start to adjust and utilize the program, but I think it's going to be finished soon, so we should have more of an update. Talk a little bit about interest rates. Of course, we're not lenders. We are realtors, but again, that's our Truth in Lending show. And then, of course, Friday finale, we'll get into the price changes in the market and see what's going on with that. I'm Connor McIver. Thank you so much for tuning in. We'll talk to you soon. Over and out.